Welcome to my first unpopular opinion that you haven't listened to video. You are all free to tell your opinion down there in the comments and just to make sure, I'm not hating any group that I say in this video. Okay, let's go. First, when we gonna talk about pave the way thingy, it's probably the Korean translator and internet. I remember when K-pop starts to entering my country, I can't help but rarely watching music video from my friend's computer and it's really hard to get the English subtitle of any variety shows. Also I don't get it when people argue about pave the way thingy because from the first generation until now, the third generation, from BoA the first K-pop idol to make it big out of Korea and save SM from bankruptcy and now with BTS sold out Rose Bowl Arena, you absolutely can't compare them with each other with all the different conditions in 2001 and 2020. And believe it or not, K-pop will make more and more milestone with new and new generation of K-pop idol coming up. 2 out of big 3 girl group, SM is the best when it comes to promote each one members. SM gives Red Velvet's members many individual chances like giving chance to Wendy Joy and Seulgi to sang many OST and featuring with many other idols such as Moonbyul, Giant Pink, Raiden and more. Give Yeri chance to produce her own music and release it from SM Station Thing, stream Dear Diary Everyone, and also Joy have being lead actress for 2 dramas and Irene being CF Queen of course. But still, when it comes to Red Velvet group promotion, SM still being sucks. If only Reviliv didn't get more lazy from time to time and stream every individual content. Third, I don't know if this is an opinion or a prediction but I think the next biggest boy group it's either TXT or 80s or Treasure. Stray Kids also a great competitor, but seeing JYP is not that great when promoting their boy group, but I still hope a great future for them, and with SM is unlikely debuting a new boy group, but maybe a new NCT unit based on different country I guess? TXT have amazing discography from Crown and Runaway and their new comeback release hopefully, plus big hit great promoting strategy. With Treasure having a really big fandom before their debuting, and yas, they gonna debut in July, and 80s which everybody already know is a stage presence king from their debuting days until now and having gold discography. I really excited to hear more from them. 4. BTS is not overrated. Period. I don't think I have to say anything more about this one. 5. The reason of many music video from SM is not have many viewers, because people who listening to their music and watching their comeback is just their fandom, except Red Velvet because they have many listeners that aren't a Reviliv. For example, idol group like Big Bang, Twice, Blackpink, BTS, G-Idol have many listeners that aren't from their fandom. Like maybe if you're a SM stan, you probably still listening to Blackpink but it's not like Blink will listening to NCT's music, I don't say that everyone do that but yeah, if that makes sense. That is all for now, thanks for watching this video, I really excited to hear your opinion as well.